Okay, this here is what I will be talking to you about today. Yeah. If I zoom myself a little bit out, and pretty much this is what it looks like. Yeah. This here, important maybe to note, manufacturer. This is where we are located right now. This here would be the street where the business where I worked is located. But this business was located in another location. I already did talked about that. The name is, I don't know, Electrosmart or whatever. The owner, the businessman, he built his business from businesses assisted from the West. Basically, this is how his business grew up. According to the Trump, he would come to it, but Trump is full of shit. I mean, this is according to the Trump. He would come to eat to this place here sometimes, probably, I have no idea, maybe 97. So I'm talking about 96 now, 97, maybe 98. His business was not located here yet. He was in another location down the road, not too far from here. What you see right here in front of you right now did not exist either in 96. In fact, if I wasn't here, if I have not seen, gone through all this here, I would not know about any of this. What was here was a little restaurant here. Actually, it was quite known restaurant. And this is what brought Trump to this location here. On which occasion he had the business owner where I worked at at the latest location. Again, this is Electrosmart or whatever the name of the company is. This owner, however, started to invest money in hotel business because he got an idea about people that would come here for business to accommodate them at a restaurant, and he started to build. So this here probably was, I think this is the building number one. I'm pretty sure that this is what it restaurant and above the building grew up. Then what happened was he expanded the business to what you see here. He got himself a conference room and he added basically another portion of the building to the primary building. This is how this building came to life. So right now I took you to year 1996, 97. I gave you the history. When it all started, he had nothing. Now, let me see one more. He's not the only businessman in this area here. This is where it all started here. This is like important place for business. Let me just see this thing here just for a second. I just want to see a little detail here. Okay, I know this. Now let's return. And I'm gonna position myself like this on the side of this building, on the side of this, what first was a restaurant. There are businesses located here behind this, and there is a parking lot. This is a small parking lot. This is where he would have his cars. Well, over time, his parking lot, where he would park, I don't even know if this was his parking lot. It would grow into a larger parking lot, and then I understand he would rent the whole parking lot. Eventually, he would get himself a fleet of cars, and he would become to rent vehicles to the guests who would come to this location here. Now the place is, the name is Borovietsky. Borovietsky, Hotel Borovietsky. You could say this German here, and this is the business I have talked about right now. Yeah? And this business was located here. What you see here, this empty here, this grass here, this is where this business was located. Up to date, they have a warehouse right here, still. And all this stuff I have pointed out that this year, this warehouse was before this, I remember the building that was here, but I did not know that it was a showroom here. Now it's here. Demolished, moved here. Right in front of the hotel, Borovietsky. This is basically the area, all this area I know about the businesses. I did not work under MKUltra only here. Not that I would work, but they did have me here also with Americans and also here. And there were some other locations, but that doesn't matter. But nowhere more than here. This is the principal location here that was located. And so when it all started from the beginning, this here, this little, he had like this parking lot, then all this expanded. And now, let me see this thing here. I don't even know if this is not completely different. I did not watch the other time, but this parking lot grew up and building and everything changed. But these people wanted me to actually work for them like 2 hours for free before they would even take me to work, basically. Work 2 hours for free so we can see how you work. And this is where Trump frequently used to lodge. This place here, Hotel Borovietsky, this also is where the conference room is and so on. Interesting place. I think I will have a little more to say about this place here. Now I'm going to play you an audio about how they wanted me to work actually for free, for which I was told they will try you to see how insane you are, because before I got this job here that lasted me a week before herniated disc symptoms would reappear again, I had to apply for about 1,000 jobs. I submitted about 1,000 job applications. Stayed a few months without the job, so I get 1 week job here and get crippled within the week, basically. Because the physician in Zgirsch just would not enter inside of the computer system what type of jobs, what am I fit for, and so on and so forth. This is just completely, completely pathetic. Did not get time to heal myself, did not get any kind of professional assistance, therapist, examinations needed to complete the whole medical procedure in respect to injury and stuff like this. Just basically thrown out on the street on a bicycle, thrown in a cold place and so on. You know, so cold place that the papers that I would have, the stack of papers, bills, documents, I would not even sort them out inside of this place, inside of this freezing apartment, because house, or whatever you want to call this garage, because it was so cold that wounds that were open, like a small micro wounds, they would just grow bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger because of the cold. It's like you put a hot dog sausage in a hot water and it just explodes and it opens up. This is how my wounds would open and would not heal, not even for 3 months at a time, it would not heal. It became questionable if it's going to heal at all because of the cold I was inside. This is how cold this place was. This is brutal. Okay, folks. Again, it's February 19 of 2020. Here's what the story is behind this hotel. It became a hotel eventually. Over time, it developed to a really decent sized hotel. At the postal office, which also I have identified, I received a phone call before entering the postal office. A phone call is like, where are you located? Come here as fast as possible. Because this was the one of the locations I have applied for work at earlier that day. And there was no job, there was no available, no nothing. And just before I would enter a really, really extremely important place, which I have identified. Now, you talk about the Polish postal office, like a main postal office, where they also had Americans work, crazy as it sounds, but proven, because I have identified one too. And you cannot go inside of the facility because it's all fenced, guarded. No way can you just get in there. Anyway, anyhow, you would not know if you would not be there. In, I don't know, 2002 and so on, 2003, whatever, 2004. Just as I was, just as my case was not 2004, but 2004, something like that, 2005. Okay, when the telephone rings that I got to go there fast as you can, how can you get here, we job for you, this and that. So, because I was here, because and I was determined to finish this first, I would not just turn around and go about like that. And so I proceeded to the postal office. Once I was done, I really rushed to this place because I need a job badly. As soon as I got to this place, I get a gentleman. He gets into my face with, this was one of the ghost workers, one of the ghost people, maintenance guy. According to him, that he did not work there and this and that, and they had a receptionist ghoster. This is a receptionist I remember far in the past. She was used whenever I was brought there with MKUltra staff members, the maintenance guy. So they had the whole crew like new, something like 2017, and the guy was new and stuff like this. What a crap. But okay, I didn't say anything. I don't need to say anything. He had a shirt, nobody. For which I was told with the big letters, nobody. If you will not be okay with Donald Trump, I will have this kind of shirt. Donald Trump is a really cool guy. This was under MKUltra, a really, really cool guy. So I come in this property now. I don't care about his shirt, about the maintenance guy's shirt. I don't care what the receptionist said. I don't care what both say when I try to identify them. I just need job, so I don't care. I just want to know what kind of job is it, and when can I start. Instead of that, a gentleman appears in front of my nose, and this gentleman also has been there for quite some time. I do not know who this gentleman is. This is a younger man. Eventually, it's possible it's one of his sons or something like this, of the owner. I have no idea who he is. I remember him seeing him in the past, but I don't know who he is. So he gets my face and he wants me to work 2 hours for free. Actually, for the first one, that I'm not sure whether this was a family member or not. For the second one, I am actually, I remember him from the past. For the first one, I don't. These are younger people. And so the first one lets me, he wants me to work for free. And I explained that in a nice way, there's no such thing like breakfast for free in this world, even since he wanted me to work in the restaurant. There's no such thing like a meal for free. And I will work over there for 2 hours for free so they could see if I can work. So they can offer me a job. This is just complete nonsense to me. I wouldn't say, they say, we're going to pay you 2 hours and you're going to work for us and we'll decide whether you are a good fit for our team here for work. But no, these people wanted me to work for free for them. I don't know, was it a 2 or 4 hours, whatever it was. And so, since I declined, he went to ask for another individual. He wanted me to wait there, that he's gonna go and talk and this and that. And then another individual came in my face, with about the same thing or whatever it was. This thing was really nasty, unfriendly, insultive, like, yeah, where are you from? You know, what, you know, this is like, Mr. Kaczynski, I don't know, Trump, they try to accent like, look, I don't even understand this, because it's like somebody would want to screw his own country deliberately or something like this. To me, it doesn't make a whole lot of sense, this whole thing. If I were a Polish person, I don't know how I would react. Not nice. If I was a person, as I am from United States, with not from United States, I'm not. I just have a US citizenship and I have European Union, Slovenian passport with me. Basically, I am like a native here in Poland, with European Union passport, and you come with a stuff like this in my face, basically treating me like I have explained in the video. I think I gestured him to go to Africa or something like this. No, if you're in Africa, do not accept a guy like this. Eventually accept him and teach him a lesson. These people like this don't deserve any place. This is not exploitation. This is just a total idiotism, stupidity. This is like testing person who was in a exposed to abuse if he is crazy enough to go to work for free. This is what this was all about. And so it really exploded. I asked him if he wanted me to call the police on his ass. Stuff like this. It developed into that. And I was the one in the end who dismissed him, ordered him to walk away from me inside of his own place. Now, I was really, really unhappy about this. This stuff can get so nasty, you have no idea what kind of stuff they prepare. All right, now let's go to the audio recording. I have explained how the place came to life. I was there. We did work in this kitchen. I worked with this maintenance guy. I was upstairs in the premises. I can describe rooms and stuff like this. Supposedly, I never was in there, and so on and so forth. Okay, that's it for this video. Oh, look at this. See this company here? I've watched from all these companies everywhere. Everywhere, all these companies here I watched. But I didn't work. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Czech Slovak?
Tak. Ale nie w tym hotelu, w ogóle w hotelu, ale nie ten.
A
w tym dopiero półtora roku.
Półtora roku, no właśnie to. Jak coś na tej gamie?
No.
I sobie zamieszamy przyjść te dokumenty, a ten drugi tylko z tego.
Dziękuję bardzo.
dobry. Witam serdecznie, Łukaszowi Zimski. Tak, bo pan, pan aplikował do nas na kuchni, chce pan przyjść.
No chciałbym przyjść, gdzie jest...
A pan pracował wcześniej na kuchni?
Płacie. Znaczy co, pracowałem jeszcze na kuchni, no, pracowałem na okrężnym ostatku zagranicznym u Stanów Zjednoczonych.
Tak. Ale w jakim charakterze pan tam pracował? Jako kto?
Service.
Jaki service?
Jako dining room service.
Room service do pokoju?
Nie.
Room service do pokoju to jest tak...
A, sprzątanie.
Ale... jak waiter, no.
Dobra,
tak. A na kuchni pan nie pracował?
Kuchni jeszcze nie pracował.
Okej, okay, a pan ma kartę pobytu? Jak to pana wygląda?
No to ja jestem z Słowenii.
Ze Słowenii, okej. Okay.
No, nie było...
Ma pan paszport?
Nie było problemu ze kuchni. Tak. Mam paszport z Słowenii i jeszcze sam wygnoszę.
Okej. Okay. Bo my generalnie zawsze bierzemy na takie jakieś 2 godziny próbne każdego pracownika i go zatrudnimy. Czy pan chce takie godziny próbne odbyć? Czy nie? Bo jeśli nie, no to my szukamy dalej.
No ja bardzo chciałbym, ale... Mówi ten angielski?
No, pomaga,
tłumaczyć.
No, to pan chciałby, to pracuje... Udajmy go. Give them an example. It's not such a thing like free breakfast in this world. And I'm saying this because a gentleman earlier asked me to work 4 hours for free. He said, you don't work 4 hours for free. So we don't do this. I'm sorry. Maybe in Poland we do such stuff, but.
Okay, no dobra. Nie, no to my tak razie dziękujemy, bo my musimy gdzieś problem na każdego. Może w innym hotelu może pan spróbować.
Może spróbować, to co prawda jest. No,
Nie, no bo wie pan, no nic nie będziemy na siłę robić, nie?
Nie, na siłę nie, tylko tu jest sąd w Polsce, nie? Wiesz? Tak są głosy w Polsce, no.
No, nie ma takiej, nie ma takiego, że ktoś musi do tego pracować, nie ma.
Jesteś, ma to prawo, ma to, tak.
No nie, dlatego my musimy wiedzieć, kogo zatrudniamy, kto nam się sprawdzi. Mówię pan, ja nie mogę dać 10 osobom umowy na dzień próbny. Dlatego tak jest to...
Jest prawda, a za co taki temat w Europie, w Unii? Muszę wyjść tam łatwo, gdzie idę, tam łatwo, gdzie nie jest sąd, nie? To jest znowu los, bo to jest tam, ale to jest. Nie są biedny rany.
Nie, no nie będziemy pan brać, to jest za dużo do życzenia. Nic, ja panu bardzo dziękuję, może kiedyś indziej pan spróbuję. Dzisiaj dziękuję.
I'm sorry I wasted my time on monkey business. I think that you are a little bit of trouble. Sorry about this.
Co? Dobrze.
Nie sami?
Jest, rozumiem.
Myślę, że jesteś mało pod dupę. Tak. Smacznie.
No. No mam, wie pan, ja wiem, no wie pan, rozumiemy, my mamy
też jeszcze będzie chcieli go, co my nazywam policję. Rozumiesz?
Tak, rozumiem.
Okej.
Do widzenia.
Bardzo dziękuję.